Hello, and welcome to ReefGrrl’s weekly reef wrap-up number 6. I started the week by clearing out a space in my fish room for a new project. More about that later. I was in the sump room well after lights out, and I had to turn the room lights on. And I'll show you something that I saw, which kind of shocked me. I posted the photo on Instagram, and I think I actually lost a few followers. You might want to look away now if you're at all sensitive. I'll tell you when it's safe to come back. Oh yes, my space invader pectinia is obviously pretty excited about something, but it's nothing I put in the tank that I know of. Okay, safe to come back. I've had high nitrates in this tank again. This is the third week in a row I've done a water change because I am determined to keep up with the water changes and stay on top of this problem. This is a big one. This is probably pretty close to 50%.
All done. They're looking for food, I think. Urchin's back up here working away. The Gorgonian's never happy because usually it's partly out of the water when I do a water change. And there we go, fresh and clean. Job's a good skimmer needs cleaning. Might do that next.
One of my favorite corals of all time was a Heliofungia actiniformis, and I finally was able to get another one. I hope I can keep this one a little longer than the last one, or maybe just not kill it with fluconazole, because honestly, I think that's what happened. Just put it in the tank about 10 minutes ago. A little concerned about how interested in it the fish seemed to be. This is later in the day, and now I have a filter on. I moved it over because it seemed like it was getting too much flow right down in the middle.
Yep, obviously that's the spot for it. I don't know, that sailfin is still too interested in it. Hell, you guys, leave this thing alone. Come on. Yeah, you. And of course, I look in here regularly with my viewer to make sure everything's okay. This is the 100 gallon where my skimmer is. And look what I noticed today. Look at that thing. That's the lemon spice favia. It came on a frag plug. It was probably maybe an inch across when I got it in November of 2019 from the KW Coral Show before the pandemic. And here are my green torch frags. There are three frags here, I believe, and each one has multiple heads. And again, they're just kind of hanging in there. I don't think the environment's ideal for them. I think they need a little more flow and a little more light. That's my green maize brain. Yep, that's the original maize brain. Fox coral. That thing has got to be a foot across. This thing is just amazing. Absolutely love it. So yeah, that's how things look in the 100 today. Frag tank update. Things are looking reasonably good. Although I believe my candy canes are bailing some polyps. I think that's what that green is. I haven't seen it move in a day or so. Maybe it's putting down roots and gonna grow a skeleton. I have no idea. But, you know, we're in a holding pattern here. I can't do another water change until Saturday, and today is Thursday. So I'm really hoping everything can just like hang in there for that little bit of time. Yeah, doing my best. This Millie, still doing well. I'm seeing a little more green now, so I know the growing tips are kind of expanding a bit. This Miyagi tort is barely hanging on. The forest fire digi is doing great. I think this might be a green slimer, not sure, and it's hanging on. Now, all of these are my bubblegum digitata frags that I took. They were getting overwhelmed with algae not even 4 days ago, and now that algae's gone. So I need to clean out the filter again. So, you know, like, I guess the frag tank is in kind of survival mode right now. And I was given a whole bunch of baby lightning dove snails. They're herbivores and they work hard. I've bought some before, adults. And Nick at the LFS pulled a whole bunch of babies out of his tank. He said he had to start getting them out of there because they're reproducing like crazy. So I'm super happy to have them. And I put some in each of my tanks. And in fact, in each of my containers here, including the shallow 50 at the top. So he probably gave me, I want to say, about 30. And so yeah, so every tank has a few. And you know, they get about half or 5/8 of an inch long, and they do a great job with the algae. I've watched them working. We did some PAR readings yesterday, and after discovering that the PAR on the bottom of this tank is barely 120, decided to move the light down a little bit. So this is the Nycru light, and it has been moved down by about an inch. So hopefully that won't be too sudden a change and it'll help a little bit. I'm thinking maybe some of these SPS, they're just not getting enough light because PAR at the very, very top was around 250. We'll see. Pectinias are looking good though. Here we are next morning. Urchins working away. And look, what a happy little guy. I'm so pleased. So obviously the fish aren't really bothering it. And this is good flow and it's enough light. So yeah, very pleased with that.
This is my new project, Sea Monkeys. Watch for the video. Well, the front half of the stand is back from the metal fabricator and the powder coating place. And take a look at this. These extra pieces were welded in and then coated to match the rest of the stand because we weren't sure whether the front edge of the too small tank was going to be properly supported across this whole span. I'm super happy with the quality of the job and it was done rather quickly. So today we're going to be leveling the stand and getting it prepared for tank move-in. I still don't know when that is, but soon. The first thing my husband did was clamped the two pieces of the stand together front to back. This was for two reasons. One was just in case someone jostled it and moved it out of position when the tank was being moved in. And the second was to be able to treat the entire stand as a single unit for the purpose of getting it leveled. He then proceeded to use shims to get the rest of the stand perfectly level. I won't give a lot of detail here because that will all be in a future video, but this is just to give you an idea of the process that we spent probably all day going through.
Prepping for the tank move-in. This green tape, this is protecting the coating of the stand because, of course, when the tank gets moved in, it's quite possible the bottom of the tank could contact that front rail when they're trying to get it up and into place. So because there's plywood attached to the bottom of the tank and it's going to look like this, this is not a smooth edge, and we're trying to minimize any damage that might happen to that front edge if it should come in contact with the bottom of the tank.
So those are the highlights from this week, and I'll leave you with a little hint of how we finish things off here. Thanks so much for watching, and if you liked the video, why not give it a thumbs up? If you're interested in what happens with this big project, why not subscribe to the channel if you haven't already? Stay safe, everybody, and I'll see you next week.